If you like this video, please subscribe to Film Companion.
Shahid, thank you so much, first of all, for making time for Counter 5. So I'm going to show you five scenes from your career. 16 years, 28 films is what IMDb says.
So I'm still under 30? You're bad, dude.
Yeah.
Not bad. I've not done so many films.
You have done so many.
You know, sometimes you cringe about the fact that you've done so many that, you know, you're like, that's so wrong. You know, because you need to give each film time and, you know, so
no,
20,
no.
It's not so bad. 20, it's not so bad. I thought I'd cross 30.
No.
Actually, I stopped counting. So, I thought I'd cross 30, but 20, it's okay.
Yeah. You can live with it.
16 years, 28 films. Yeah, that's less than 2 films a year. So, that's okay. Mm. I'm okay with that.
So, I want you, Shahid, to watch the scene and then just go back to what you can remember. Just deconstruct it for us. What was your brief? How did you get into
so
character?
I have a terrible memory, but I'll try my best.
Huh.
I might be the wrong candidate for your show, but I'll still put my best foot forward.
मुझे कुछ याद नहीं है।
ये कौन सी पिक्चर है?
That's right.
हैं? मैं था इसमें? Are you sure that's me?
No, we're relying on you to do better than that. Let's start at the beginning, okay. 2003.
Wow.
Yes.
You've not done anything, it's not starting.
It's not starting.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Mr. Spencer College, Rajiv, Mathur. That's me. Tall. Not bad. Hey, mal hai. Handsome. Chal cute.
You're gonna get very cringy expressions.
Good looks ke saath, good taste kyun nahi deta? Nahi to ho sakta hai ki mere jaisa dude, mere jaisa akela reh jata. Aakhir kya hai ye studs of Spencer College, Javed aur Danny mein, jo mujh mein nahi? But just you wait and watch Mr. Javed and Mr. Danny. Ab na main look kha rehne wala hu aur na mera best friend. Mambo. Mambo yoga.
Oh God.
Why?
Oh God. I cringe when I watch a lot of my work from the past because I don't know, I just feel like I was so bad.
But you weren't so bad. It's so fresh and kind of, you know.
Yeah, but you know, fresh is just a, you know, it's not a word that you can attribute to yourself and say that, you know, it was my achievement or it was my work. Mm-hmm. Freshness happens to be, you know, it's just because you're new.
Right.
You know, and if you have a slightly pleasing personality, people tend to kind of forgive you for all your imperfections and stuff, you know. But, you know, I mean, I just look at it and I feel like, I guess I was right for the film.
Yeah.
Because I didn't need to be anything more than what it is. He has these rough edges and I think that kind of works for the character. What do I remember about this scene? Well, we shot this scene on a 23-hour shoot day. So yeah, we did have long days. Ishq Vishk was a film full of newcomers and we had a very tight budget. And this was one of those days when we had to finish a lot of work in one day because this was Rajiv's house, Rajiv Mathur.
Yeah.
And so we had to finish all of his work in one day, all that house car work in one day. And so we, I think, took this shot around 1 in the morning or something. And so I was extremely exhausted. That's one thing that I remember.
How many takes?
I think 10 or 11 takes.
Wow.
Because it's like, you know, it's just
it's
me ranting.
Way. Yeah.
And you know, usually at that time,
it's a monologue.
It's a monologue,
yeah.
Kind of. I've done a few.
Yeah. yes.
Just come to think of it, this is also my introduction shot. So
correct.
My career kind of started with monologues. I never really thought about that.
Right.
So I guess that makes like poetic justice or whatever. Weird.
You knew your lines? Are you
I knew my lines so well that sometimes the director had to tell me like, Shahid, you know them too well. Make them sound like they're just coming out of your mouth.
Right.
Not like you, you know.
Because
I was super enthusiastic, excited and like stuff. But I was very nervous before this shot. Like for me, this shot, I was more nervous before this shot than I was before my Heather speech.
Really?
Yeah, because it was a monologue and it was for the first time that I was going to do something like that.
Yeah.
And it was my introduction. You know, so I was like, dude, this is the first time people are going to watch me and if
and
they
if
don't
they
like
me,
the
yeah,
first 40
yeah.
seconds of what I'm doing,
correct.
The director can't even like cut and go somewhere else because
right.
it's that's the shot, right?
Right?
So, and the directors had also, you know, Ken had also built it up saying that, bro, you know, you need to be an actor and you need to be able to hold this shot for 30 seconds, you know. So, I was really nervous before this shot.
How old were you?
I was 22. Yeah, I was quite young. 22 today, I think, is a lot more grown up than
it
22.
Is. Back then.
15, 16 years back,
yeah.
And I was, I was just like this kid from Lokhandwala who didn't really know too much, but just really wanted to be in front of the camera. And I thought I knew how to act, but I kind of knew how to be comfortable in front of the camera. I was, like you said, kind of fresh. And
it's very endearing.
Of course, it is. It is, you know? But not for me. I'm happy it is endearing for you. For me, it's a little cringy. I'm like, kya kar raha hu main? I could have done so much better than that. But I mean, a lot of people think that I'm a star kid or something. But actually, you know, I never lived with my dad. And when I got cast for this film, they didn't even know I'm his son.
Right.
You know, that happened much later because I never really presented myself like that because it was a complicated family dynamic. So every time I go for an audition, I'm not going to sit down and explain to them, aisa hua tha, phir na phir waisa ho gaya tha, phir aisa ho gaya tha. Isle yaar, main ye hoon, lekin tujhe pata nahi hai, lekin main ye hoon.
Right.
You know, so it's a bit complicated. So I was like, I used to just, you know, say, okay, my name is Shahid and it used to.
And move on.
And move on.
Yeah, right.
So I remember my mom, actually a lot of what you see of me in this film came from the support that my mom gave me. She was almost every day on the set with me.
Really?
Yeah. And
but you didn't find that
distracting? I used to seek her out. I was not that confident where I would tell her that, you know, I know what I'm doing.
Mm.
You know, I think that's something that exists in this generation a lot more than that generation.
Right.
And I think that's really good. Mm. I think people are very confident and very prepared. And people kind of are very self-assured and they know what they want to do. They've already decided in their heads and all. You can see all that, you know, with actors today. I have no idea what I'm going to do. I was like, mom, just stick around. Because if I'm messing up, like, I want to like have somebody who I really trust, who I've grown up with. Also, you know, my mom was always an aspiring actor. She was a wonderful Kathak dancer. Yeah. She was a very good actor. Mm. She did try to her hand at mainstream cinema and you know, things didn't work out exactly the way that she would have. So it was almost like we were doing this together.
Right.
You know, like a part of my debut was also a part of her dream. You know,
she's so living through you.
She did live through me in many ways, especially, you know, we had a big struggle and, you know, it was always a dream, a very far away dream that I would be in front of the camera and be a mainstream Hindi film actor.
Yeah.
It was just like something that we told ourselves ki ye hoga. But deep down you knew that it might never happen.
Yeah.
So when it was happening, I wanted her by my side, you know, because that was the moment. And it
so
was,
she would do the 23-hour days?
Man, she would just stay as much as I would ask her to stay. And you know how we are as children. Acha mom, now you leave.
Huh.
And she would leave. You know what I'm saying? Like, so unconditional.
That's
like,
amazing.
I could just like tell her to be there
and
when I
wanted. And she didn't make you conscious?
No. In fact, I would always look at the director. And right after looking at the director, I would look at my mom. And you know, that reassurance from her would mean the world to me.
Right.
You know? So I think I needed that in my first. But that's the only time.
Yeah.
After that, never. You know?
Yeah.
She never came. In fact, she's hardly ever come on my film sets.
Right.
But that time, it really mattered and she was there. So I'll always
so
be
lovely.
Thankful to her for that. She was always there, always like, you can do better. You know that used
really?
To
be
that. Yeah.
She would tell you, you could do better.
Yeah.
She wasn't willing to just say brilliant and,
not
know.
At all. Huh. Not at all. I mean, we had quite an honest relationship. Mm-hmm. And I think at that time, we used to have film cameras.
2003,
yeah,
it would
yeah.
be on film.
So,
yeah.
So one other thing that was a massive thing was, you know, Rostock.
Right.
I think it was
you
like
only have that much.
$10,000 for 4,000 feet. And 4,000 feet would last about 4 minutes or something.
Yeah,
maybe I'm saying wrong. But 4-5 minutes ka hota
tha,
you know. Or the more you use, that pressure of budget used to start building on
Correct.
You. You know, today it's like you can use it like trash.
Yeah.
You know, it doesn't matter.
Keep going.
And that's massive.
That's
like when
massive,
you know that you have only so many opportunities and every opportunity has a cost attached to it, changes everything, right? I mean, today it's like we can keep farting around if we want and then when we get it, we get it. You know, it's like everything can be a rehearsal and everything can be, let's just see how it goes, you know.
Right.
That time it was like, you know, it's not like a live performance, but kind of.
Because
you're going to get 8 or 9 shots and then the director's going to turn around and say, dude, I can't waste any more, you know, Rostock on you. We're moving on.
Mm.
I'll make the most of what I can.
And you were aware of this at 22.
Oh, yeah. I've assisted in direction and stuff.
Right.
When you're dying to be an actor, you do all your research.
Yeah.
You know, you find out everything that you can find out about. So, you know, I did my bit,
Nice. Okay, let's go to scene number 2.
You know what, Geet? Tumhari ye manohar kahaniyan wali philosophy hai na, ise tum apne paas rakho. Right now you're coming with me.
Tum mujhe force nahi kar sakte ho, Aditya.
Of course kar sakta hu, Geet. Geet, you're coming with
me. Aditya,
white in this. Why are you so white?
Ab chale? Ya aur natak karna hai. Ye meri zindagi hai. Chale jao yahan se. Akela chhod do mujhe and all that.
Aditya.
Now that's a nice scene. That's a legit nice scene, you know, even 10 years, 15 years down the line, if I was to look back at that, I'd say like, that was a nice scene.
Yeah.
Can't it's say that really about the scene we saw before. Just like, I got lucky. This is a legit nice scene. It's actually a very memorable scene for most people.
I love when you just pause when she says, iska ye matlab nahi ki tumhara chance hai, and he says, dhyan rakho.
That's actually the nicest part of this character and their yeah. relationship. You know, mm. it was one of the first films where the hero of the film wasn't, you know, loved by the heroine of the film right. madly. And right. you know, it was a very real kind mm. of a mm. take at how the two protagonists, or the hero heroine of the film, and how their relationship can be, and you know. So yeah, I remember this day was a bad day for me, you know, in the sense that, you know, when you keep shooting back to back to back to back to back, there is always that one day or that some moment that you reach, and you know, it's something you battle, and I think you get better, I think, with time, because you learn to be aware of the fact that you will get spent at some point. Mm. And so you need to be very
you need to conserve.
You need to be very, very, very kind of instinctively aware of how you are going to conserve your energy and, mm. and be aware of the scenes that are going to be demanding, and keep yourself entrenched in the character. You know, you have to keep yourself wet.
Right.
You know,
right.
Because every day it's almost like the character is going to like do that to you, you know.
Yeah.
So, all the...
So, you've been shooting a long time for Jab
We Met. This was towards the end of the schedule.
Right.
And I was just not being able to feel the emotion. And I know people really like this scene, but I was pushing. I was actually pushing the emotion this day, and therefore the you know, it's very out there.
Right.
I'm like, I'm really like, you know, really saying my lines, and yeah. I'm really, you can yeah. see the neck, and you can, yeah. because I was not feeling it enough. And so I was feeling the need to compensate for that right. and, you know, perform more. You know, that happens with actors, and it's a very internal thing. And I think it's very few directors, I think it's more to do with your relationship with the filmmaker mm. where they know. But you know, right? You know when you're giving a shot, and you know when you're feeling the shot.
And you know, if you're not feeling it, there's no way to put it on.
The audience won't always know that
right. you're not but you know.
But you know, and it's impossible to feel every moment mm. Completely. You know, I don't know. There might be some actors out there who can say that they felt every second, but I mean, I'm human yeah. and I have days where I'm just on and it's just flowing, and there are days where I feel like
you have
know,
to strain a little more.
I need to, like, honestly, acting comes naturally to me. A lot of people think that I'm a method actor and all this, because it's, you know, the roles that I play are very complex, and I don't, like, wherever people have liked me, it's been different from what they've seen me in the past, and that's been the reason why people like me. Yeah. Array, he surprised me, did something different. So. But I'm not, with time, I have become very instinctive. Like, I started off with a lot of thoughts, and I was process oriented, and you know, I used to put a lot of brain, mm. you know, into it. It was an intellectual process, and over a period of time, it became a very emotional process. It became a very organic process. It became a very, it stopped becoming a process. It just right. started happening, mm. you know, and I feel that
it's like a gut reaction.
It just needs to be what it is, and just, you need to flow with it. It's like energy, yeah. you know, I think. Yeah. And the better you get at that, the less your performances become, you know, you can't feel the effort.
Yeah.
You know, that effortlessness starts coming in. And sometimes, you know, the problem with the audience and filmmakers, my point of view as an actor sometimes, is that just being effortless becomes being a great actor. Mm. But you have to be effortless in different things.
Right.
When you learn to become like a Meryl Streep,
right.
you know, you see her perform and she does such different roles, but she's effortless in all those characters. Being effortless at being yourself is somebody who's good at emoting. But I think being a great actor is about being effortless at different people, mm. different characters, you know, representing different energies, and that to me is really great acting. Mm. And that requires time and effort and having a very open mind and not being full of yourself and trusting yourself at the same time, and trusting your actors, trusting the cameraman, just allowing yourself to let loose and discover. You know, it becomes a journey of discovery as opposed to I want to do this right. And I'm going to go achieve that. It's not like
you fully plan it out.
Yeah,
and
it's not
it.
Like
yeah.
a, you know, like yeah, like a house that you're building that you need to break it down. It's
but when at this point you feel you were still doing that.
I was very. In fact, I remember Imtiaz once had a chat with me, and we were in Manali, and he just took me for a walk. And I used to take a lot of pride in the fact that I was very prepared. Okay, and he just took me and he put his arm around me. He said, "You know, Shahid, you're a good actor. Just stop thinking about it. Just be." And I looked at him and I felt damn upset. I was like, yaar, mere effort ko ye aise matlab, don't you appreciate the effort I put in? And I think that reflects in this character, you know, because there are certain things about the way he talks.
A little rigid,
They are, you know, it looks like they're, you know, you can see straight lines and it's geometric.
Correct.
You know, it's not fluid, you know.
Yeah.
And that really worked for Aditya Kashyap, you know, because I think that contrast between how he was and how Geet was is what made the film what it is.
Absolutely.
And so I guess I was right for the part. This is one of my favorite scenes. I did struggle a lot on this scene.
You did?
I did struggle a lot. And yeah, it's a lovely scene. It's a very nice scene.
So when you look back, you're happy?
I'm happy because I've done other things after that.
Right. Which we're going to get to.
Which were decent. You know, so this kind of works in the, you know, sometimes things that are limitations actually end up working in your favor. So it works in different ways. It's weird like that.
Yeah. Okay.
हमें तो भाई भाई छुटवा
It's very nice that you chose a scene of Guddus because I felt that the poor guy got overshadowed by Charlie.
Yeah.
Because everybody was so into Charlie.
एक जैसे होते हैं भैया You are great भैया गाने में तो बिल्कुल नहीं अटकता ये आगे
I think Vishal sir, like when he gets his dark sarcasm right, is untouchable.
Yeah,
like, he's at another bloody level.
This
I don't
is
know
like
how
so
he
funny
it's
and
so
scary.
Exactly, you know. It's so awesome when he does that.
And you're so afraid for this poor guy, you know.
Yeah, yeah, like I can feel that, you know, that tension
correct,
in the
correct.
Room and I'm
yeah.
not even there, but I can feel
yeah.
it. Like, I'm like, what's going to happen to him now?
Right, right.
Agar teri ungli ek khoke ki ho.
And we used to be laughing before the scene. Because it's so bloody funny when
it
you read funny. The line and you read the scene
right.
and when he says this again, teri ungli, you're like, dude, that's really fun. And then you have to go out there and really do it.
Yeah.
Like, this is serious shit. It's going down right now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, it's not funny.
Bahane karke lege dil, das bahane karke
You know, I don't know. Like, he is so commercial. Some, some this deep part of Vishal sir is just so commercial.
Yeah.
10 खोके का पाउडर है उस गिटार में।
Love this background.
और तेरे पंजे।
देख 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 देख
देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख देख and we need to do it in a manner where at no point do people feel like it's a scene. Mm-hmm. You really need to feel like this is happening. And the first conversation that me and Vishal sir had about Kaminey was, he said, you know, both my heroes have a speech defect. And at no point in time do I want people to feel that we are making fun of people who have speech defects. So
it's just who they are.
It is who they are. And we need people to relate to them at every level. People should feel what they're feeling, understand them as people. And yeah, they should be no different from any other character. You know? So that was the challenge. The challenge was to, you know, be able to make people feel how it is to be there. Because then you can't make fun of it.
Right.
You know, then it touches you somewhere deep down. and that makes impact, and that would probably be more relevant than just having a scene where which is funny and you're just like, kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So I met a lot of people who had speech defects, and there's a reason why people stammer. It's different from something like lisping. Lisping is more of a technicality. It's a physiological problem, but stammering is a psychological problem. Mm. And it's amazing, you know, the kind of stories I heard when they told me why they started stammering. And as a parent today, when I look back, it's of great help, because a lot of times it happens when you're spoken to very strongly, or you see something that's too much for you to absorb as a child, and because of that, you know, it just becomes turns into a physical problem, because psychologically you've been so affected. So that was amazing to know.
But Shahid, until this point, until Kaminey, you're doing films. Many of them were love stories. It felt like this was really like a massive leap.
It was. I mean, you it know? Was.
It was.
Yeah,
right?
Of for course. You as Before an actor. This, I was doing that typical shit. You know what I'm saying? This is the first time I actually, got the opportunity, and fortunately with a great filmmaker.
Yeah.
In great form.
Yeah.
At a time in his life when he was raring to go, you know, and so was I.
Yeah.
And he just, God sent him to me, because I'd had done nothing to deserve this opportunity. I don't know what in his head made him decide ke Shahid ko lete hain roles ke liye. And then when he threw it at me, I was like, wow.
Yeah.
You know, here's an opportunity to really change it up.
But did you ever have a moment of, what if I just can't do it? Like, are those kind of self-doubts ever in there?
The only reason I'm sitting here today, and I think I always, it's really stupid, but I always thought ke main bahut achha actor hoon aur main bahut bada star banunga. Like, that was just like set in my head. Mm. It was set.
You knew this.
I mean, I believed it.
Right.
Is it the truth? I'm still figuring out, you know what I'm saying? But there was this voice inside me which gave me that drive.
For me, this was the first time you really sort of...
You're highbrow, bro. Like, you know, you're the cream of the, you know, the most snooty critics. There's those three posts that you're always shitting about, that they are going to trash me only. She's one of them. So, chalo, I made some impact. Yeah.
You did. I love this movie.
Thank you so
love much. Love Kaminey. And let's go on to another performance that I love.
Oh, Jay.
Chana?
Ye...
kya hai? Kab bada ho gaya tu?
Kaminey.
Ye sab...
Yaad hai? Bachpan mein tu kya kehta tha?
Kya?
Bada ho ke moje se nikah karunga. Aur roz raat aake doctor sahab aur mere beech mein so jata tha. Acha, doctor sahab mujhe chhoote bhi the na? तो लड़ता था उनसे तू
और अब तो उनके भाई आपको छूते हैं अब क्या करूं मैं
आपको बांटने का दिल नहीं करता मुझे
जहर खूबसूरत है आप
अमेजिंग लव
लाइंस डूड
व्हाट लाइंस
Lines he writes, man. What lines he writes. I think it's the lines that, you know, the great dialogue writers have written that give actors the opportunity to show complexity, to be able to throw the audience off or, you know, make impact in a manner which... Because it's the words that come out of your mouth.
Yeah.
I mean, if the words don't provide you that opportunity, then, you know, then there's no point.
Mm.
Because you can't force something that doesn't already exist. You can only take from what's in the script, you know. And of course, there are films which are great because of the screenplay, because of the drama, because of the emotion. But for an actor, I mean, when you get lines which have this kind of, you know, just lines which are so kick-ass. Yeah. That's all you can say. Yeah. They're just kick-ass lines, you know. Yeah. It's you know.
Tell me, when you have a line like that, or a... उनके भाई आपको छूते हैं तो मैं क्या करूं हाउ डू यू डिसाइड हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू प्ले इट बिकॉज
इट वाज वेरी इंस्टिंक्टिव बिकॉज आई वाज ऑलरेडी प्रीटी इंट्रेंच्ड इनटू द कैरेक्टर एंड इट फेल्ट लाइक समथिंग आई कांट हेल्प एंड समथिंग दैट पेन्स मी सो डीपली बट इट इज व्हाट इट इज सो इट जस्ट यू नो समटाइम्स यू से you remember something from the past and you're just like, and that happened, you know, it's that kind of a thing for him, because he can't help it, that, you know, and now his brother touches you.
Yeah.
It's such a simple scene. Actually, it happened very simply. We didn't really work at it much. We just shot it. And, you know, Tabu is a great actor. Yeah. I mean, she's just one of the finest actors of her generation. And she's just getting better and better and better with time. Because I think it's not really about her getting better. It's just about people recognizing who she is and giving her opportunities. And cinema reaching a stage where it deserves her, so to say.
Yeah.
You know, because the films that she did initially, the characters in the films were so, you know,
yeah.
There was nothing great there.
Correct.
But today, because that stuff is happening and when people think about who can do it, it's only her. Yeah. She's the only one who can do stuff like this. And she's still so beautiful and young and she still doesn't really have that motherly quality.
Yeah.
That's what made this equation work.
Right.
You know, if you had somebody who was maybe older and, and you know, then that oddness.
No.
Especially that moment when he puts that itar on her and he gives her a peck on her neck.
Yeah.
You know, so without saying anything, so much is being said.
Yeah.
And I was very clear about the fact that I don't want to ever use it as a tool to titillate the audience. Mm. It has to be something that makes you uncomfortable.
Right. And it does.
Yeah. So it was always meant to be like that people should feel uncomfortable. They should not like what's happening, you know. But the characters can't be uncomfortable.
Right, because this is who they are.
But the mood has to make you feel like that.
Yeah. What does Vishal do for you that no other director does?
I don't know. I think, you know, some things are destined.
Mm.
You know, certain equations are destined. And there's always somebody who brings the best out in you. And I think Vishal sir is that person in my life. He's brought the best out in me. And I think every actor is fortunate to find one or two people like that. You're not going to find too many.
Right.
It's just something which is special, and he makes me look better than I am. I don't know. I mean, it's his lines. It's so many things. It can't be explained. Everybody in the films that he does are great. You know.
Yeah.
Everybody is suddenly at another level.
Correct.
So it obviously has to do with the filmmaker's craft.
Does he do anything specific with you in his briefing? In his sort of just what he wants from characters?
He just scares the shit out of you.
How?
By giving you the part. You know, he writes something and he gives it to you, and you're like. How? But can't let it go. It's such a great opportunity.
Right.
So you put yourself in that position where you can't let it go, but you're so scared of messing it up or falling short. You know, and with Hamlet, you always fall short.
Right.
It's that kind of character.
Oh my God! What a complicated role it is.
It's the choices that we make that make us who we are, and he makes great choices for actors for sure.
Okay, last one.
ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਇਨਸਪੀਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਚੱਕਰ ਵਿੱਚ
ਹੈ ਜੀ
ਮੁੰਡਾ ਜੇਲ ਹੋ
ਗਿਆ ਲਵ ਸਤੀਸ਼ ਅੰਕਲ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਸ਼ਾਟ ਇਸ ਸੋ ਗੁੱਡ
ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ 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 ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ 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 ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ ਬੂਮ ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ ਚਿਕ ਬੂਮ
ਡਿਸਾਈਡ ਕਰੂਗਾ ਤੂੰ ਤੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਕੰਸੈਂਟ ਕਰ ਲੈ ਬਸ ਭੈਣ ਚੋਦ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਗੋਲੀ ਮਾਰੇਗਾ ਤੂੰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਸਾਰਾ ਸਟਾਰ ਬਣਾ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਮੇਰਾ ਪਿਓ ਭੈਣ ਚੋਦ ਗੋਲੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਛੱਡ ਛੁੱਟ ਕੇ ਜੇ ਤੇਰੀ ਛੋਟੀ ਭੈਣ ਦਾ ਵਿਆਹ ਕਰਾਂਗਾ ਤੂੰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਗੋਲੀ ਮਾਰੇਗਾ ਮਾਰ 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 ਮਾਰ
Oh, it was a great scene, man. That was a great
scene. I love the expression on your face.
Love this scene. I love this scene. And then you show me this again. Shut this.
Okay, shut this.
No, that was such a nice scene. Such a nice scene. Actually, that's probably one of my favorite scenes in the film, but people liked a lot of other scenes and, you know, especially the parts where he's all snorting up and coking up and all, you know.
Right.
weirdly, those are the louder things that people tend to, you know, get affected by, and you know, but these are the things that you do roles for, you know, these are the kind of scenes you do roles for. Such a nice scene, man. Actually, I had so much fun watching it because I haven't really seen it for really long. So it was really nice to see us, like, nice to like look at something and say like, yeah, I was a part of this, you know.
Yeah.
It's a great feeling.
And again, a sense of, you don't know whether to laugh, you don't know whether to be afraid, you know, it's
find Tommy's character very funny.
He is very funny.
You know, as an audience, like as a reader, when I was being read the part, I was just cracking up because I just found him like extremely stupid and highly entertaining and just a mess, you know.
Right.
And I'm right, very much the opposite of that as a person. Like, my whole life I've spent keeping it together. That's the kind of person that I am. And people tell me that, you know, just relax, kar.
Right.
You know, I'm
very like, let go.
Yeah, you know, so it was completely the opposite. And like, you know, how he's saying that, you know, main London jana hai, you know, and my interpretation of, in one line of the character actually has been shown very, like, it's as close to that interpretation. In my head, he was a 5-year-old Punjabi child who didn't know what the hell he wants, and he was lost.
Right.
Okay, so my entire, because if you don't show him as an overgrown child, you can't forgive him for the things that he does. You know, when, you know, whether it's your kids or whether it's, you know, your cousins or somebody else's children, when they do something wrong, you know they don't know any better. Mm. So what you tend to do is you tend to try and explain it to them. You'll get irritated with them, you'll get angry with them, but you'll never hold them responsible for their actions and, you know, things.
Sure.
And that was the only way that we could have got Tommy to be liked and loved. Otherwise, he would be hated.
Right.
And if he was hated, we'd lose the purpose. And the purpose was to take people through the journey of an addict, you know, and to make them understand what's going on in their heads and what all they're dealing with. Because only then they can be compassionate towards them and kind of, if they ever have to engage with one, they can deal with him the right way.
Mm.
You know, and I'm sure we'll all at some point in time come across somebody who's having an issue with addiction. We all have our issues with addiction of different things in life.
Yeah.
So, you know, this is just a very out there version of that. And in this scene, I feel he is as childish.
Correct.
And as vulnerable and as just, you know, stupid as he can be. This is literally shouting like a kid in a candy store saying, you know, I want that chocolate. It's literally like that, you know, mummy, mummy, make a chocolate.
Correct.
So that's what he's doing. London jana. He's just, you know, he's just there. And Satish Uncle is so good at
this.
He's
so good.
So bloody good. Yeah, I had so much fun working with him, and you know.
But Shahid, when you do a role like this, is there ever any vanity about how you're going to come off? Or are you, as an actor,
what do you mean when you say vanity? Like, you
vanity know, meaning?
I just find it interesting how people ask actors about vanity. Like, what is their interpretation of vanity? And
only that, so even as a really messed up drug addict, I should sort of look good.
But I have to, because he's also a rock star.
Right. No.
I mean, this guy, like Kabir Singh can't.
Correct.
If Kabir Singh starts looking like, wow, he's looking so hot, then I played it completely wrong. And that was the biggest struggle. And that's the biggest difference between Tommy Singh and Kabir Singh. Both of them are Singhs.
Correct.
I just realized. Is that Tommy Singh is this guy who people look up to, and he's a star and he's a celebrity, and his introduction is, you know, singing in a studio, and then you see him performing on stage, and you know, so he's meant to be this
larger than life
guy. Yeah. But at the same time, he's completely screwed, and he is an addict. And I needed to get both those things going. So it was so difficult to achieve it, because cocaine addicts tend to lose a lot of weight, and you know, and as a star, he needed to have a good body. We wanted to do the whole tattoo thing with him.
Right.
And so it was really tough to find that, to bring both those things together. It's easy when you have a brief that's kind of single dimensional. It's difficult when you have a brief which is so like opposing to each other. Like, he's a drug addict, so he should look effed,
right?
And he is this rock star, so he should look amazing.
Correct.
So like, how do you, like, what do you do with that?
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So we just like figured some way of doing it, and you know, it's not about looking good. It's about playing a character that's very attractive. And I think being attractive doesn't come from looks. I think it comes from how the audience feels when they watch a character on screen. That doesn't just have to. Yeah, of course, it's good looking, but that's boring.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, that's boring. I got that for the first 4 years of my career, and then I was like,
It's done.
You know, like, let somebody else do it.
Right.
You know, I'm bored.
Right.
You know, and I can get bored easily. You know, I need to stay interested. That's one of my issues. Like, by the time I'm finishing a movie, 2-3 days before, I start telling people around me, "Yaar, ho gaya, I'm now done." So, and they're like, they get really thrown off. Like, what do you mean? This character still needs so much from you. And I'm like, yeah, but like, I've given everything. Now I want to go. It's like that.
Mujhe
ghar jaana hai. So yeah, I mean, I wanted Tommy to look attractive. I wanted people to be attracted to him because I couldn't have people respect him, appreciate him, or, you know, none of those things. Because, you know, handsome is as handsome does. There's nothing this guy was doing that was, you know, nice. So he had to have that for the right balance. You know, otherwise sometimes you can get very put off by a character.
Yeah.
And I'm happy to play a character where people get put off by me. But then that character shouldn't be a character which needs to be redeemed or a character who's lost. And my first feeling about Tommy was that he's lost.
Yeah.
And when somebody's lost, then you need people to feel for them. So,
right.
I had to do all those things.
Right. But when you look back at all these scenes, Shah, do you feel...
First of all, I must say that I'm really... I actually really enjoyed the scenes you chose. I kind of knew the movies you'll choose, but I enjoyed the fact that you chose the, not the scenes, like with Haider, you didn't choose the speech.
Correct.
And say with Tommy Singh, you didn't choose the portion where he's passed out, or the scene with Alia, you chose this scene. So, so I appreciate that, because, you know, some of those are my favorite scenes, but, you know, people don't really talk about them. So it was nice that you addressed some of those scenes.
Shahid, when you look back, do you feel like you can pat yourself on the back and say, good job?
No, you know, it's kind of, it's weirdly like the opposite kind of feeling, you know, like it makes you feel like, at least like right now how I'm feeling, it kind of makes you feel nostalgic, and you do feel a bit emotional, because the most of the characters that I've played have taken a lot from me, you know, so they are a part of me in some way. And it's been 15-16 years I've been doing this, and a lot of these roles have been spread over time. So, you know that these are special opportunities that come your way. And I feel very thankful, very, very thankful to all the filmmakers who gave me these opportunities. And to God, of course, that he, you know, gave me this, made me an actor. You know, I never thought I would be one. And I feel really, I hope that I get more opportunities like this, you know, because they don't come by every day. And this is what I really love. I feel like it would be a life well spent if I could do this for another 15-20 years, you know, get a few more of these and really be able to sink my teeth inside and give people an experience that makes impact somehow, you know, because I think that that's the most beautiful thing about cinema, and that's the least, that's the last thing that we tend to focus on, because it's surrounded by so many of these tropes, you know, the bells and whistles. अच्छे कपड़े एक तो ये अच्छे कपड़े पहनने से एक्टर क्यों बनता है आदमी मुझे ये समझ में नहीं आ रहा है व्हाई वी आर गोइंग दिस वे वेयर यू नो इट्स बिकमिंग सो ड्रिवन बाय सोशल मीडिया दैट यू आर सो कॉन्शियस अबाउट योर फिजिकल अपीयरेंस
करेक्ट
यू नो योर फोकस इज सो मच ऑन दैट दैट स्टेपिंग आउट ऑफ योर हाउस समबडी इज क्लिकिंग यू एंड पोस्टिंग इट समवेयर योर ब्लडी यू नो इट्स बिकमिंग लाइक अ लाइक व्हाट्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन फैशन वीक एंड एक्टर्स आई मीन आर वी सपोज टू बी you know, like fitness, you know, like people you emulate who are very fit. So are we meant to be athletes? Are we meant to be fashionistas? Or are we meant to be actors? I mean, there is, it's, you know, it's getting very complicated, and it's getting very stupid.
Yeah.
You know, we're missing the point. And the point is people walk into the theater to have an experience which makes some impact with them emotionally and touches their soul at some level. And that has nothing to do with clothes on your body. You know,
fully
so I've done it myself, you know, so I mean, with time I've learned that there's more to life than just being narcissistic and wanting to look amazing and go, hey, you know, there's much more to life than that, you know. You want people to love you for the roles you play and for what you made them feel like, you know, that's really being what being an actor is. I remember seeing Harrison Ford's interview, you know, about Indiana Jones and one of the Indiana Jones, and somebody asked him, so do you do all your stunts yourself? And he said, I'm an actor. They have a stuntman for that, because that's what he does, and I act, you know, so sometimes you know, so simply he said everything that needed to be said, that let's understand who we are, you know, what my job profile is, you know, because that profile is getting altered for all the wrong reasons. And so these are the roles which helped me. You know, I think film acting and filmmaking is a very cathartic process. You know, it can have a deep impact on others, and you cannot make deep impact with other people if you haven't made it with yourself. Yeah. I think somewhere the roles that you play, the films that you do, they really somewhere play a huge part in who you are as a person and your understanding of life, your understanding of relationships, your understanding of people. And I think that is the deepest and the most beautiful part of this job. And I hope I get more roles where I can experience that.
I'm sure you will, Shai. This was so much fun.
Thank you. I had a blast. Even though we didn't know how to use that laptop. But we got through. Just as how pretty much most of my career was. I never knew I'm going to do it, but I got through. It was nice.
Thank you.
So if you like this video, please subscribe to Film Companion. And if you like one of those scenes, if you have a favorite scene, don't forget to leave a comment.